So aapka saman vagaira ho gaya, saman etc. is over, and the date of first hearing is there, and on the date of first hearing, we presume an ideal situation that the WS also has been filed on the first hearing, and the plaintiff plus the defendant, both of them are there before the court on the first hearing. Either their counsel is there, or with the counsel some agent is there, or the plaintiff and defendant themselves are present. We are visualizing an ideal situation. But otherwise, I have told you already that first hearing pe aisa kuch hota nahi hai. First hearing pe to pehle defendant bolta hai ki mujhe document nahi mile, document do. Theek? To document lega, uske baad phir next date pe wo jaake apna WS file karega. First hearing pe actually aisa hota hai. Phir replication, rejoinder, etc. bhi hota hai. So we are presuming an ideal situation. We are presuming an ideal situation where या फिर मान लो कि फर्स्ट हियरिंग पे सब हुआ, डॉक्यूमेंट्स लेके गया डिफेंडेंट एंड उसके बाद डब्ल्यू एस फाइल कर दिया. तो जिस दिन डिफेंडेंट ने डब्ल्यू एस फाइल कर दिया, हम उस दिन की बात करें, बी इट द फर्स्ट हियरिंग और बी इट सम अदर डेट. ऑन द डेट व्हेन द डब्ल्यू एस हैज बीन फाइल्ड, द प्लेंटिव एंड डिफेंडेंट आर प्रेजेंट बिफोर द कोर्ट. आइदर द प्लेंटिव विल बी देयर एंड द डिफेंडेंट, और देयर लॉयर्स विल बी देयर, और देयर लॉयर्स विल बी अकम्पनीड बाई सम एजेंट. या फिर प्लेंटिव डिपेंडेंट हैं प्लस साथ में लॉयर्स भी हैं. सिविल मैटर में पर्सनली अपीयर होना जरूरी नहीं है ना, अनलेस द कोर्ट हैज आस्क्ड यू टू अपीयर इन पर्सन. सो वट एवर बी द केस, नाउ यू सी द मेन पॉइंट, द कोर्ट अल्टीमेटली हैज टू गो फॉर ट्रायल, एंड ट्रायल कैन नॉट बी डन अनलेस द कोर्ट हैज इश्यूज बिफोर इट, एंड अनलेस द कोर्ट नोज as to who has the burden of proof. The court jab tak settlement of issues nahi karega, the issues on which evidences are to be recorded, and unless the court is sure about who has the burden of proof, usko aap onus of proof bhi bolte hain, so the court cannot initiate the trial. Plus now, particularly after the 2002 amendments, the court also has to see whether it actually needs to go for the trial or not, or whether before the getting into the trial, is it not ADR sufficient, alternate dispute resolution. So agar ADR sufficient hai to humko trial mein jane ki zarurat hi nahi hai. We don't need to frame the issues, we don't need to go into the trial, let the matter be adjudicated beyond the court, out of court. So all these things have to be decided. I am repeating, we have presumed a situation where the summons was served, the defendant has filed the written statement, and now the court has to decide, number one, whether it has to go send the matter for ADR, alternate dispute resolution, or if no ADR, then it has to go for settlement of issues, so that after the settlement of issues, the trial can be started. And when the court goes for settlement of issues, the court has to decide upon the burden of proof also. And you must appreciate that in order to understand whether the case is fit for ADR, and to understand whether if it is not fit for ADR, then what should be the issues between the parties settled on which evidences will be recorded, for that the court needs to know exactly what are the facts pleaded by the plaintiff, what are the facts pleaded by the defendant, and on what facts the opposite party has admitted in his pleadings, and on what facts he has denied in his pleadings. So admissions or denials, admissions and denials is the first step. Admissions and denials. Finding out the admissions and denials is the first step before the court goes into deciding upon the ADR mechanism, and also deciding upon as to what will be the issues which have to be settled in the case on which the trial will take place. Ab admissions and denials ke liye, the court has the plaint, so the various facts are pleaded in the plaint, and then the court has the written statement, the various points of reply to those facts are there in the written statement. Now you may find that there are certain facts of the plaint which have been admitted in the written statement, either expressly or by deemed admission, and there are certain facts in the plain which have been denied either expressly or by necessary implication in the written statement. But every fact you may not find to be denied. Her fact expressly denied nahi hoga. There may be certain facts in which neither the concept of deemed admission is applicable nor it is found to be expressly denied. To wahan pe fir there you will have to see as to what does the defendant have to say. And similarly, the facts which the additional facts which the defendant has pleaded, what is the statement of the ab zaruri ne dhyan dena zaruri to nahi hai na ki defendant ke written statement mein jo naye points likhe gaye hain apart from the pleadings of the plaintiff, whatever new facts have been written, it is not necessary that the defendant plaintiff has filed a replication. I told you the theory of assumed traverse and confession and avoidance yesterday only, I believe, or in the Sunday's class. Now, it is not necessary that the defendant should has filed a replication only. So, jo facts defendant ne extra plead kiye hain apart from the pleadings of the plaintiff, he may plead some additional facts for which I told you replication is filed, but ho sakta the plaintiff has not filed the replication. That is not essential always. So, whether the plaintiff admits those facts or denies those facts, now that has to be found out by the court. And how will the court find it out? By oral examination of the parties. Similarly, maan lo plaintiff ne kaha hai that the plaintiff has been in possession of house number so and so, and the defendant has been interfering in his possession. See? That plaintiff has been in possession of so and so house number, and the defendant has been interfering in the possession. अब डिफेंडेंट का रिप्लाई डिनायल अगर करना है, अगर वो मान लो इंटरफियरेंस को डिनाई करना चाहता है, तो वैसे लिखेगा दैट द डिफेंडेंट एडमिट्स दैट द प्लेंटिफ हैज बीन इन पोजेशन, बट द डिफेंडेंट वेहमेंटली डिनाइज दैट ही हैज बीन काउजिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ इंटरफियरेंस. ठीक. बट व्हाट द डिफेंडेंट राइट्स इज, व्हाट द डिफेंडेंट राइट्स इन हिज रिप्लाई इज दैट the defendant denies that the plaintiff has been in possession of the said property. अब मैं interfere कर रहा हूं कि नहीं उस पर तो defendant ने कुछ बोला ही नहीं, उस fact को deny नहीं कर रहा ना admit कर रहा है, लेकिन यह कह रहा है कि उसके possession को मैं deny कर रहा हूं. अब here the court has a confusion, are you denying or admitting the fact of interference? अब defendant का कहना है कि उसके possession में ही नहीं है तो मैं interfere क्या करूंगा. डिफेंडेंट तो ये कह रहा है ना कि दैट इज नॉट इन हिज पोजेशन, सो ऑब्वियसली हिज इम्प्लीकेशन इज दैट सिंस इट इज नॉट इन हिज पोजेशन, सो देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ माई डिनाई माई इंटरफियरिंग इन इट. सो द कोर्ट इज नॉट वेरी क्लियर ऑन दिस पॉइंट. सो कोर्ट कैन आस्क ओरल क्वेश्चन टू द डिफेंडेंट वेदर यू एडमिट द फैक्ट और यू डिनाई द फैक्ट. ही विल से दैट आई डिनाई द फैक्ट ऑफ पोजेशन एंड आई ऑल्सो डिनाई द फैक्ट ऑफ इंटरफियरेंस. तो मीन्स सिर्फ आपके प्लीडिंग से कई बार कोर्ट को ये क्लियर नहीं हो पाता कि आप उस फैक्ट को एडमिट कर रहे हो या फिर डिनाई कर रहे हो. ठीक. और एक्चुअली होता प्रैक्टिस में ये होता है, इन एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस नॉर्मली इट हैपेंस दैट ऑन द फर्स्ट डेट ऑफ हियरिंग और वॉट एवर डेट ऑफ हियरिंग द प्लेंटिव एंड डिफेंडेंट आर प्रेजेंट और देयर काउंसिल्स आर प्रेजेंट, एजेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट, एंड द कोर्ट हैज बिफोर इटसेल्फ द प्लेंट एंड द रिटन स्टेटमेंट. Now the court has to decide whether it will go for ADR or it will go for settlement of issues. Okay? And we are presuming that there is no application for replication and rejoinder on the that date of hearing. So court has to. अब ऐसा नहीं होता कि court room में बैठ के जज साहब पहले pleadings पढ़ेंगे, पूरे court को बिठा रखा है, पहले pleadings पढ़ेंगे बारी बारी से plaint और WS और फिर उनसे सवाल पूछेंगे. Practice practically ऐसा होता नहीं है. Practically they have the plaint and the written statement. Court upar upar jo facts pleaded hai seedha us pe admission or denial puch lete hain. At times the court need not read the written statement also. Matlab ideal situation to ye kehta hai ki aapko pehle dono padhna chahiye, but the burden on the court and the paucity of time etc. So court will open the plaint and it will one by one read the plaint facts and ask him orally about the fact whether he admits or denies. What facts he admits and what facts he denies, and that will be taken on record. Lekin isme court ko cautious ye rehna padta hai that if the plaintiff has stated a fact and the defendant has admitted that fact in his written pleadings, but in the oral examination he says that I deny, will that be allowed? So in that case the court will stick to the written pleadings. Nahi samajh mein aaya? Plaintiff ne koi ek fact plead kiya apne plaint mein, to court ne WS nahi padha, court ne seedha defendant se pucha, do you admit or do you deny the fact? These are all very formal proceedings that take place in the court. The defendant says that I deny that fact. Ab ye record pe aa gaya, recorded, because that admission and denial will be recorded. Now the court will, obviously the court has to see the written statement, and in the written statement it is written that the plaintiff defendant has expressly admitted that fact. So will the oral denial override the written admission? Answer is no. So court has to do a balance there. The court has to look at the pleadings also, and the court has to look at the oral admissions and denials. Particularly oral admissions and denials are required in those cases where the pleadings are not very clear. In those cases where the pleadings are not very clear, so jahan jahan pleadings mein doubt hai aapko, expressly ya by necessary implication denied nahi hai, ya fir expressly ya by deemed admission admitted nahi hai, there is some confusion, so court particularly has to examine the plaintiff or the defendant on those points. And if the plaintiff or defendant is not present, then obviously some agent will be there, the counsel will be there, they will be taking care of that. Lekin maan lo aapka agent present hai, aap khud nahi ho, and the agent is not able to give the reasonable answers on admissions and denials, then what? The court will go for summoning the party himself. 7 days ka notice jayega aapke paas. Within 7 days you have to appear in the court on so and so date. And the party will be personally examined. Now this admissions and denials is basically done to have a clear understanding of the issues on the point of conflict between the parties. Obviously you know that whatever pleading has, whatever fact has been admitted, so that will be deemed to be proved, that will be said to be proved by admission in pleadings. But then again we have discussed already ki jahan jahan admissions ho gaya hai, jahan jahan admissions hua, jo nahi ki court usko proved mane, court can still require the plaintiff to prove that fact. Ye sab to aapko pata hai na, this we have already discussed. So wherever admissions are there, generally the court will go for deeming it to be proved by the admissions and pleadings. But wherever denial is there, the court will go for settling the issues. And that issue, the court will decide as to who has the burden of proving. Ab aapne ek fact plead kiya aur maine deny kiya. Main simple deny kar raha hu, koi additional suggestion nahi de raha hu. To phir burden of proving that will lie upon you. आपने कोई एक फैक्ट प्रूव किया, प्लीड किया, मैंने डिनाई किया, लेकिन साथ में मैंने एडिशनल कोई सजेशन दे दिया, कोई और फैक्ट प्लीड कर दिया, तो उस फैक्ट को प्लीड करने का बर्डन फिर मेरा होगा. सो दैट विल बी द ओनर्स ऑफ प्रूफ, बट दैट इज रिलेटेड टू सेटलमेंट ऑफ इश्यूज, दैट कम्स लेटर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट एडमिशंस एंड डिनायल्स एंड ऑल्सो ADR. क्योंकि एडमिशंस एंड डिनायल्स के प्रोसेस में द कोर्ट विल एग्जामिन द पार्टीज to examine whether the party is admitting or denying a particular fact, and in that the oral statement of the party in order 10, rule 1 in particular, and then you have got rule 2 and rule 3 also, plus the written pleadings of the parties, all that will be together examined to find out as to what facts have been admitted and what facts have been denied. Is that fine? Isi process mein, in the same process, the court also has to understand whether an alternate dispute, alternate bolte hain, alternative bolte hain, alternative, So whether alternative dispute resolution mechanism is possible in this case or not. Ab inka dispute ka nature, when you are doing admissions and denials, you have to also see the nature of the dispute and whether an amicable settlement outside the court is possible or not. And if possible, then whether it will be by arbitration, by conciliation, by judicial settlement, by mediation, by lok adalat, etc. Ye char panch mechanisms hain. So court will examine that also. And the court will see as to what could be the terms on which the parties could settle their dispute out of the court. So ye sab bhi isi process mein hota hai. And therefore, when you read order 10, rule 1A and 1B and 1C, they are related to ADR to be read together with section 89. So ADR is one mechanism. ADR is one mechanism. And examination for admissions, oral examination for admissions and denials is another mechanism. So we have to now discuss these two things one by one. First of all, we need to read the Bare Act for admissions and denials. Uske baad fir hum ADR mein jayenge. I hope you have understood the context of the topic. Kyunki maine aapko pehle bataya ki pehle din aisa nahi hota. Pehle din hoga kya? Reality mein pehle din kya hoga? The plaintiff will appear, the defendant will appear, the defendant will ask for the documents. And he will take the documents and seek time for filing the WS, and then the court will fix next date and then he will file the WS. Usi samay ho sakta hai WS ko dekhkar the plaintiff will ya fir next date pe wo WS nahi file karta balki pleadings dekhkar he files his interrogatories, which I told you in actual practice interrogatories ka practice zyada hai nahi, but the defendant may file his interrogatories. Ab the plaintiff will file the answer on affidavit to the interrogatories. Now once the interrogatories have been filed, so now the defendant will take the interrogatories answer from the court and he will file the written statement. Now when he files the written statement, the plaintiff may apply for interrogatories. He may file his own interrogatories. Uska interrogatories aa gaya, uske baad, I'm talking about a very long process. Normally in actual practice, 90-95% cases mein interrogatories lawyer file nahi karte. लेकिन द पॉइंट इज दैट कर सकते हैं. तो प्लेंटिव ने अपने इंटरोगेटरीज लगाए, अब डिफेंडेंट उसका जवाब देगा ऑन एफिडेविट. जब जवाब मिल गया तो अब प्लेंटिव कहता है मुझे रेप्लिकेशन फाइल करना है, उसमें टाइम जाएगा. अब उसने रेप्लिकेशन फाइल किया, उसके बाद डिफेंडेंट कहता है मैं तो रिजॉइंडर फाइल करूँगा, तो उसमें टाइम गया. ठीक. सो ये सब करने कराने के बाद तब नौबत आएगी order 10 rule 1 ki, that is admissions and denials. So it depends. Now we were talking about an ideal situation, but it depends upon how the process goes, and a lot of discretion lies in the hands of the court in such situations. Theek hai. So the next topic will be admissions and denials, order 10 rule 1 and sorry, thank you, God bless you. The next topic will be admissions and denials, and after that we get into ADR. So can I take a break? God bless you. Thank you. So we are talking about admissions and denials and then ADR. I'll take a break here. Order 10. We are first talking about admissions and denials. At the first hearing of the suit, the court shall ascertain from each party or his pleader whether he admits or denies such allegations of fact as are made in the plaint or written statement, if any, of the opposite party. If any, matlab written statement agar file hua hai tab na. क्योंकि देखो सारे फैक्ट्स अगर एडमिट हो गए, इफ ऑन द फर्स्ट हियरिंग इफ ऑल फैक्ट्स आर एडमिटेड, ठीक, रिटन स्टेटमेंट में प्लस ओरली आल्सो ऑल द फैक्ट्स आर एडमिटेड, देन देयर एंड देन द कोर्ट कैन गो फॉर ऑर्डर 12 रूल 6. WS मान लो फाइल हुआ है, WS फाइल हुआ है लेकिन ऑल द फैक्ट्स हैव बीन एडमिटेड, सो द कोर्ट कैन गो फॉर ऑर्डर 12 रूल 6 एंड यू नो दैट ऑर्डर 8 रूल 5 सब रूल 2 विल ऑल्सो अप्लाई because the facts have been admitted. So, but directly under order 12 rule 6, the court can pass the judgment there and then in favor of the plaintiff if the on the first hearing, the defendant admits all the facts, all the pleadings of the plaint, then the court can go for passing the judgment under Order 12, Rule 6 in favor of the plaintiff, or the court, in its discretion, may require the plaintiff to prove the facts. All the facts or some of the facts. Now, how the court exercises that discretion, in the earlier class, I have already explained to you. So, let's presume that all the facts are not admitted. Let's presume that all the facts are not admitted, and therefore a judgment forthwith is not passed. I'm reading that rule again. At the first hearing of the suit, the court shall ascertain from each party or its pleader whether he admits or denies such allegations of fact as are made in the plaint or written statement, if any, of the opposite party, and as are not expressly or by necessary implication admitted or denied by the party against whom they are made, the court shall record such admissions and denials. So basically, yahan pe to ye suggestion hai. Here the suggestion is that court must examine the plaint first, then examine the written statement first, and the court must see as to what facts are admitted expressly or by deemed admission, and what facts are denied expressly or by necessary implication, and whatever facts the court has a doubt whether it has been admitted or denied, the court will ask questions on those facts. But in actual practice, the court normally asks questions on all the facts, but then you cannot go against, the party cannot go against whatever he has done in the written pleadings. So these admissions and denials will be recorded by the court. Purpose is what? Purpose is to decide, number one, whether ADR should be done or not, and number two, as to what should be the issues between the parties. Issues will be framed only on those facts which have been denied. Then rule two, dekho. At the first hearing of the suit, the court shall, with a view to elucidating matters in controversy in the suit, examine orally such of the parties of the suit appearing in person or present in court as it deems fit, and may orally examine any person able to answer any material question relating to the suit by whom any party appearing in person or present in the court or his pleader is accompanied. Kai bar kya hoga na? The party bhi present hai, the party is also present, but maybe the party is illiterate and he is not much aware of the things. But he has got an agent, कोई पढ़ा लिखा agent है उसका, relative है, जो कि सारे material questions को answer कर सकता है. Then that person can be examined by the court. या फिर party है नहीं, only his agent is there in the court, so that agent will be examined. Then they are saying, at any subsequent hearing, the court may orally examine any party appearing in person or present in the court, or any person able to answer any material question relating to the suit by whom such party or pleader is represented. So it is not necessary that you examine them in the first hearing itself. If the need arises, you can examine them on a subsequent hearing also. And the basic purpose is, dekho, this has to be a bit flexible. The basic purpose is to understand the real controversy between the parties, and also to see whether ADR is suitable in that case, and also to see as to what are the issues between the parties. तो उसके लिए दिस प्रोसेस इज अ बिट फ्लेक्सिबल. फर्स्ट डेट पे कर लो, जरूरत पड़े तो नेक्स्ट हियरिंग पे भी कर लो आप. देन द कोर्ट मे विट थिंग्स फिट पुट इन द कोर्स ऑफ एन एग्जामिनेशन अंडर दिस रूल क्वेश्चन सजेस्टेड बाय आइदर पार्टी. व्हाट इज दिस क्वेश्चन सजेस्टेड बाय आइदर पार्टी? दिस इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड इंटेरोगेटरीज. क्वेश्चन सजेस्टेड बाय either of the parties. So that is what is called interrogatories. Kahan pe de rakha interrogatories? Order 11, rule 1 onwards, dekhoge, you will find the points of interrogatories. Then third rule, the substance of the examination shall be reduced to writing by the judge and shall form a part of the record. So whatever examination you are doing, that should be taken on record. Next, rule 4, where the pleader or any party who appears by a pleader or any such person accompanying a pleader as is referred to in rule 2 refuses or is unable to answer any material question relating to the suit which the court is of opinion that the party whom he represents ought to answer and is likely to be able to answer if interrogated in person. Now what happens here is, the party himself is not present, he has sent a lawyer or he has sent an agent with the lawyer. So either the lawyer is examined or the agent is examined. Now when the agent is examined, suppose the agent is or the lawyer is not able to answer a particular question, but the court believes that the party, if he is summoned in person and he is examined, he will be answering that. So in that case, what will the court do? Court 7 din ka notice dega, 7 din mein party ko khud appear hona padega, likha hoga aage, and is likely to be able to answer if interrogated in person. The court may postpone the hearing of the suit to a day not later than 7 days from the date of first hearing and direct that such party shall appear in person on that day. And direct that such party shall appear in person on that day. If such party fails without lawful excuse to appear in person on the day so appointed, the court may pronounce judgment against him or make such order in relation to the suit as it thinks fit. Ab 7 din mein nahi aaoge, genuine ground hai, court time extend kar sakta hai. Any other likha hai na, make such order in relation to the suit. So date extend kar sakta hai. Adjourn karke ek aur date laga diya, agar genuine ground hai to. Otherwise the court can go against the party, may decide the case against that particular party. That's all. If such party fails without lawful excuse to appear in person on the day so appointed, the court may pronounce the judgment against him or make such order in relation to the suit as it thinks fit. So such order means what? Cost imposed karke next date of hearing laga lega, us date pe aap appear ho jao. So this is what you have got related to admissions and denial. So basic point that bear act padh lena do teen bar, but basic point that you have to keep in mind is that the examination should be of the parties, and that is an oral examination, and that has to be recorded. But if the party does not appear, then the lawyer represents him, and maybe with the lawyer some agent may be there, so this agent will be examined. Or if the agent is not there, then the lawyer will be examined. Now if the lawyer or the agent are not able to give the answers to certain questions, so in that case the court will postpone the proceedings for 7 days, or 7 days ke andar it will call the party himself to appear in person and then examine the party. If the party does not appear in 7 days, then the court can either fix another date, extension of time, or the court can go for deciding the suit against the party. But then the court again is flexible here. So itni aasani se court case ko decide nahi kar dega, rather the court will always go for koi bol raha hai kya kuch nahi, rather the court will go for extending the time. Cost will be imposed upon the party. That's it. Now next we have to go into ADR. Now next we have to discuss ADR. Ab dekho, when you talk about ADR, the first thing you keep in mind is that ADR is settlement of the matter out of court. ADR is settlement of the matter out of court. And there are a few mechanisms of ADR which have been provided in the CPC. One is arbitration. The other one is conciliation. Conciliation mein single L hoga na. Then the other one is mediation. Then you have Lok Adalat, and then you have finally judicial settlement. Now when you say judicial settlement, you do not mean that it is deciding the case. Wo to court karega hi karega na. Agar ADR nahi fulfill ho paya, satisfy successful ho paya, the court will go for judicial settlement. So, court will go for judicial determination by the process of trial. But when we say judicial settlement, so basically we are talking not about trial, etc. We are talking about a judge-assisted compromise between the parties. So, judge will be not deciding and taking evidences. He will just be helping them in entering into a mutual settlement. So, these are the five mechanisms. And now, which mechanism is to be adopted in which case, that we have to discuss later on. So, ye char mechanism de rakha hai. What happens is, suppose the suit is filed here. Is date pe suit file hua. After the suit, suppose the WS is filed on this date. And I hope you know that in between summons, etc. will be served. WS is filed here, and maybe on the same date or some other date, the examination of parties. Means admissions and denials are recorded. WS is in file hua hai, to normally first date of hearing pe WS file hoga, normally, unless the defendant seeks time. So, WS ke baad, jis din WS file hua, usi din examination ho jayega, ya fir for some reasons, on the next or next to next date of hearing, the examination will be done. So, this is admissions and denials recorded under Order 10, Rule 1, Rule 2, Rule 3, Rule 4. This we have already discussed. So, ye aapka admissions and denials ho gaya. At this stage only, the court has to see whether an amicable settlement out of court is possible in the case or not. Not whether they will enter into an amicable settlement. Wo to parties ke discretion pe hai. Lekin kam se kam possible hai ki nahi. Ab there are some disputes where such a settlement will not be possible. To usko hum kehte hain unsuitable cases. And there are some situations where such settlement is possible, they will be called suitable cases. Now in AFCON's infrastructure case, the court has given you a broad list of that, but that list is only illustrative. The court has to apply its own judicial mind also. Now suppose the court finds that the case is suitable. Means suitable means what? Out of court ADR mechanism is possible. In that case, the court will formulate the terms of that possible settlement. Terms ka matlab ye nahi ki court batayega ki tum aise compromise karo. Bas ek general sa suggestion hoga parties ko ki is matter mein tum out of court settlement kar lo to achha hoga, tumhare paise bachenge, time bachega. And the purpose is, you see, purpose is what? Speedy justice. Now speedy justice by the process of trial ho ya by ADR mechanism ho, that ultimately helps in conserving the right to life and personal liberty under Article 21. So ADR ka purpose hai speedy justice, which will save the time, anxiety cost, money, plus which will save the courts from excessive litigation also. So un sab ko bachane ke liye ADR mechanism has been provided. Parties ka time bachega, parties ka kharcha bachega, cost expenses bachega, parties ka anxiety cost bachega. Anxiety cost kya hota hai? Plea bargaining ka bhi to yahi purpose hai. Tell me, what is anxiety cost? Medical, mental, anxiety, mental, mental trauma or harassment, and that may result into obviously some medical expenses also. So that cost will be saved, and that cost does not mean only money. Anxiety cost would mean it would affect your work performance also. Ab aap work ka office mein, jaise mera hi le lo, main padhata hu yahan pe, ab mujhe kisi baat ki anxiety ho jaye to main kam se kam jab tak wo anxiety hai main padha nahi paunga effectively, to mera kaam bhi to affected hota hai, mere relations affected honge. Theek, so similarly, so that is anxiety cost. Wo aapka save hoga, plus court ke upar overburdening of litigation, that will be avoided. Aur case proceedings mein, trial proceedings mein parties ki animosity aur badhti hai. With the process, with the progress of the suit in the trial, the animosity of the parties further increases. So if you go for ADR settlement, mutual adjustment, So that animosity will not be rising beyond a limit. So all those benefits are there, and ultimately the most important benefit is speedy justice. ADR speedy justice का मतलब ये नहीं कि हमेशा trial से ही आपको speedy justice मिलेगा. आप ADR arbitration वगैरह करवा लो, mediation करवा लो, जल्दी आपका matter solve हो जाएगा. So that is also speedy justice. So that is the broad purpose of the ADR mechanism. Now what happens is the court finds that there is a possibility of an ADR mechanism in that out of court settlement. The court will formulate the suggestions. Now court will formulate the suggestions means it is aisa koi formal nahi hota ki these are the terms on which you have to settle your dispute. The court is not going to suggest that. The court is simply going to suggest to the parties that you can better get your dispute adjusted out of court. ठीक. और उसके बाद court party से पूछेगा कि which of the five mechanisms you want to go for. ठीक. The most important and the best would be arbitration. Best would be arbitration. अगर आप arbitration में जाना चाहते हो तो आप arbitration में चले जाओ. लेकिन arbitration में matter तभी जा पाएगा. The matter can go for arbitration only when the parties have consented for arbitration and they have also agreed to the arbitrator. So if the parties do not agree for arbitration or arbitrator, then the court will never send it for arbitration. Then the court will next think of conciliation. There also the consent of the parties will be required. So if the parties agree for conciliation, then that is fine. Or otherwise, अगर अग्री नहीं करते हैं तो आर्बिट्रेशन कंसीलिएशन में मैटर नहीं जाएगा. देन द नेक्स्ट वन विल बी देर आर थ्री ऑप्शंस, लोक अदालत एंड देन यू हैव गॉट मीडिएशन एंड जुडिशियल सेटलमेंट. अब एज फार एज लोक अदालत इज कंसर्न, इफ द मैटर इज सिंपल एंड द लीगल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ सेटलमेंट आर स्ट्रेट सिंपल, कॉम्प्लिकेटेड मैटर नहीं है, देन द कोर्ट विल गो फॉर लोक अदालत. जहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा कॉम्प्लिकेशंस नहीं है मैटर में, जैसे मोटर एक्सीडेंट्स हो गया, इस तरह का छोटा मोटा मैटर्स, तो वहाँ पे आप लोक अदालत में भेजोगे. ठीक. लेकिन अगर मैटर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है, लीगल प्रिंसिपल्स कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हैं और सेटलमेंट उनका जो डिस्प्यूट है दैट इज़ वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड और इट रिक्वायर्स सेवरल राउंड्स ऑफ नेगोशिएशंस, पर्सनल एनिमोसिटी का मामला है, दो पड़ोसी हैं आपस में उनको ईगो क्लैश हो गया है, लैंडलॉर्ड टेनेंट का ईगो क्लैश चल रहा है, कंज्यूमर का जो वो सप्लायर है उसके साथ ईगो क्लैश चल रहा है, या फिर उसके साथ कुछ डिस्प्यूट है जहां बार बार बैठना पड़ेगा, तो क्योंकि लोक अदालत तो एक बार में डिसाइड करता है ना, तो यहां पे यू विल गो फॉर मीडिएशन. मीडिएशन वेयर द मीडिएटर विल मेक देम सिट टुगेदर इन सेवरल राउंड्स एंड द मीडिएटर विल मेक देम कम टू अ कॉमन अग्रीमेंट. And if the mediation also is not suitable there, then the court will go for judicial settlement. या फिर कई बार क्या होता है कि mediation available नहीं है, हर court में mediator नहीं होता ना, हर court में normally mediation cell होगा, but अभी उतना develop नहीं हुआ mechanism, तो हर court में mediation cell नहीं होगा, तो there the court will go for judge assisted settlement where if I am the court where the matter is pending, I will transfer it to, not the case, that mechanism of ADR, I will send it to some other judge. Wo judges ka apna ek list hota hai, uske paas bhej dunga, wo dono ko bitha ke aapas mein negotiation kara ke unka settlement karwane ki koshish karta hai. He may suggest to them some legal points also. Thik? So that is the fifth measure. Thik? Ab aapne media usme bhej diya ADR mein, when you send it for ADR, so there you will fix a date. Do dates fix hote hain. Ek to ye date hoga ki kis date ko aapko wahan appear hona ADR mechanism ke liye, aur ek time period specify hota hai ki kitne dinon mein that ADR mechanism has to be completed and the matter has to be reported to the court. Aur zyada time nahi dete hain, 2 hafte, 3 hafte, 1 mahina maximum, matlab ye na to bahut zyada ho gaya. So it is not that the court will give too long a time. If the extension is asked by the ADR personnel, then you give the extension of time. So ek to time doge ki ADR mechanism ke liye aapko kab appear hona, dusra ADR complete karke the report has to be filed on so and so date. Ab jaise mediation hai, ab every court, again when I say every court I am not meaning every court in India, but cities mein khas karke most of the courts, they will be having affiliated with them the mediation cell. और उसका जो हेड करेंगे, हेड मतलब उसको जो कंट्रोल और रेगुलेट करेंगे, दैट इज़ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लीगल सर्विसेज अथॉरिटी, ठीक, DLSA, ठीक. और एक CGM रैंक के ऑफिसर विल बी द चेयरमैन ऑफ द DLSA, ठीक. तो व्हाट विल हैपन इज द कोर्ट विल फिक्स, सपोज उसने डिसाइड किया कोर्ट ने कि दिस मीडिएटर के थ्रू हम इसको सेटल करवाएंगे, तो कोर्ट विल सेंड द मैटर टू द DLSA. DLSA will fix the person who is going to mediate. Ab wo person either he will be a lawyer, har court ka apna ek mediation panel hota hai, either he will be a lawyer or he can be a judge, not the same judge, some other judge, theek. Uske paas matter chala jayega, aapko itne tarikh ko uske paas appear hona hai, aur usko ek guideline hoga kitne dinon mein aapko decide karke mediate karke report back karna hai. So this is broadly how it happens. This is broadly how it happens. The lawyers are trained. Lawyers ko training di jati hai for ADR. So there will be a panel of mediators. So this is broadly how. Ab ye sab karne ke baad, if the ADR mechanism is successful, it will be reported back to the court that inka aapas mein settlement ho gaya. These are the terms of settlement. Aur agar waisa hai, to phir the court will draw a compromise decree. अब आर्बिट्रेशन के केस में तो चलो आर्बिट्रल अवार्ड होगा एंड देन अकॉर्डिंग टू द आर्बिट्रेशन एक्ट थिंग्स विल गो, बट अदर केसेस, उन केसेस में द कोर्ट विल ड्रॉ अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज डिक्री अकॉर्डिंग टू द टर्म्स ऑफ देयर अग्रीमेंट. एंड इफ द ADR मैकेनिज्म फेल्स, देन द कोर्ट विल रिकॉर्ड दैट फैक्ट दैट इट हैज फेल्ड फॉर सो एंड सो रीजंस. वो रिपोर्ट जो आएगा ADR मैकेनिज्म का, दैट विल बी फाइल्ड, एंड उसके बाद द कोर्ट विल गो फॉर सेटलमेंट ऑफ इश्यूज एंड कंडक्टिंग द trial. Is that fine? You have got two important cases on ADR. One is ek to aapko Salem advocate case hai, ye to likhwa diya na citation abhi, aur dusra hai Afcons Infrastructure Limited. Versus Cherian Warke Construction Company Private Limited versus Cherian 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 Warke Construction Company Private Limited. Now the judgment was delivered by R.V. Ravindran Justice. It was a two judges bench. Judgment is 2010 Supreme Court. 2010 Supreme Court. It was a two judges bench. And the judgment was delivered by Honorable R.V. Ravindran Justice. ठीक है, अगर आप ये दो केसेस पढ़ लेते हैं ढंग से तो आपका ADR बिल्कुल तैयार हो जाएगा. अब आपने आर्बिट्रेशन पढ़ा होगा तो यू कैन गेट इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन व्हिच इज़ नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस पर्पस. ADR के लिए आपको वो सब पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. और केस मैंने आपको दिया है, आई प्रोवाइडेड यू द केस, उसमें पेज नंबर 45 निकालना, एफकॉन्स वाले केस का पेज 45, द एफकॉन्स केस पेज 45 मिल गया. हाँ नहीं, ऊपर लिखा है ना पेज नंबर, जो केस का पेज नंबर है, एफकॉन्स केस खोलिए, उसमें ऊपर केस का पेज नंबर लिखा है तो उसमें 45 और नीचे लिखा है पेज नंबर 22 वट एवर. अच्छा मेरे में दूसरा है ना इसी, इसमें पैरा नंबर 43 यू विल फाइंड दैट द समरी ऑफ द एडीआर प्रोसेस इज गिवन हियर एंड आई हैव रिटन द मार्जिनल नोट्स देयर. पॉइंट नंबर वन देखो, द प्लीडिंग्स आर कंप्लीट. मैंने जो लिखा है मार्जिनल नोट वो पढ़ रहा हूँ. द प्लीडिंग्स आर कंप्लीट एंड देन सी द नेचर ऑफ द डिस्प्यूट अपॉन द प्रिलिमिनरी हियरिंग ऑफ द पार्टीज. इसी में आपको एडमिशन डिनाइल्स वगैरह करना होता है. दूसरे साइड में आ जाओ तो पॉइंट नंबर टू देखो, इफ इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर ADR देन रिकॉर्ड वाई इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर ADR. इफ इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर ADR देन रिकॉर्ड वाई इट इज़ नॉट फिट फॉर ADR. एंड उसके बाद सेटलमेंट ऑफ इश्यूज करो और ट्रायल करो. ठीक. एंड फिर लेफ्ट साइड में आ जाओ, थर्ड पॉइंट, इफ इट इज सूटेबल फॉर ADR एक्सप्लेन द चॉइस टू द पार्टीज. वो जो क्वेश्चन फॉर्मुलेट करने की बात है दैट इज हियर दैट द कोर्ट विल क्वेश्चन नहीं सॉरी टर्म्स फॉर्मुलेट करने के बाद तो कोर्ट विल सिंपली टेल द पार्टीज. व्हेन आई रीड द बेयर एक्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन दैट टू यू. अभी तो मैं ओवरव्यू दे रहा हूँ, बेयर एक्ट पढ़ना बाकी है अभी. द कोर्ट विल टेल दैट यू कैन सेटल योर डिस्प्यूट इन सच एंड सच मैनर एंड वॉट इज योर रिस्पॉन्स टू दैट. ठीक. एंड द कोर्ट विल एक्सप्लेन टू देम दैट दीज आर द फाइव mechanism by which you can settle and which of the mechanisms you want. Then फिर इस साइड आ जाओ, फोर्थ पॉइंट, आर्बिट्रेशन अगर चूज करना है तो ओनली इफ द पार्टीज हैव कंसेंट आउटसाइड द एम्बिट ऑफ द कोर्ट. अगर एक बार आर्बिट्रेशन में भेज दिया तो दैट मैटर गोज बियॉन्ड द एम्बिट ऑफ द कोर्ट. अब आर्बिट्रेटर डिसाइड करेगा. एंड कॉस्ट हैज टू बी बोर्न बाय द पार्टीज and the party should agree upon also the arbitrator. Size xeroxing mein thoda sa cut gaya hai wala side mein. Then fifth point pe aa jao left side mein, if arbitrator does not agree upon arbitration is not agreed upon then they will be asked whether they agree for conciliation. If they agree for conciliation then conciliation ke liye bhej dijiye. Uske baad sixth pe aa jaiye, point right side mein, if not agreed to arbitration and conciliation then mediation, lok adalat aur judicial settlement. Aur in teenon ke liye fir parties ke consensus ki zarurat nahi hai. Theek hai. Fir next page mein jaiye, right side mein seventh point, jaise motor accidents claim wala point likha hai maine, legal principles are settled and no personal animosity, these are simple cases, so where lok adalat. Fir point number b dekhiye aap, complicated cases, several rounds of negotiations are involved, then mediation. And number C, mediation not available or parties agree for judge's guidance, then judge assisted settlement and the matter will be referred to another judge. ठीक, वही same judge नहीं करेंगे. And then फिर वहाँ से आप चले जाओ left side में, point number 8, if ADR fails, it will be recorded and the court will continue with settlement of issues. Point number 9 उसके ठीक नीचे और नहीं 9 के पहले, if ADR succeeds then order 23 rule 3 के अंदर a compromise decree can be made. ठीक. फिर उसके बाद point number 9 उसके नीचे, if other disputes are also included, अगर और भी disputes included हैं तो उसके लिए provisions लिख रखा है कि क्या आप apply करोगे, वो पैरा नंबर I में आप देख लीजिएगा. फिर वहाँ से आप राइट साइड में जाओ, पॉइंट नंबर 10, अगर कोर्ट ने पाया कि इनका अग्रीमेंट एक्सप्रेसाई इलीगल है, द कॉम्प्रोमाइज दैट दे हैव मेड इज इलीगल, देन द कोर्ट शैल ड्रॉ देयर अटेंशन टू दैट, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली इलीगैलिटी के बेसिस पे उसको कल को चैलेंज किया जा सकता है. सो कोर्ट विल ब्रिंग दैट फैक्ट टू देयर नोटिस सो दैट इलीगैलिटी इज रिमूव्ड, ताकि फर्दर प्रोसीडिंग्स के चांसेस खत्म हो जाए. एंड पॉइंट नंबर 11, for ADR mechanism there is no elaborate order needed. मतलब बहुत डिटेल्ड ऑर्डर की ज़रूरत नहीं है, आप ब्रीफ में लिख दोगे कि सो एंड सो मैकेनिज्म वॉज देयर and it was not suitable, yeah, it got defeated, yeah, phir it was successful, whatever. So the bahut detailed order ki zarurat nahi padti, because that is not basically a judicial order. No, wo jo ADR ka jo bhi process hua hai uska jo final settlement hoga to wo koi trial pe to order hua nahi hai, and therefore aapko bahut zyada in depth detailed order jane ki dalne ki zarurat nahi hai. Why it is a suitable case ye likhoge, why it is not a suitable case ye likhoge, why the ADR mechanism failed wo short mein likhoge, and it is successful then what is the ultimate compromise wo aap likhoge. And then fir udhar right side mein point number 12, no need to separately formulate and reformulate, is pe main baad mein aaunga. 13, judicial settlement agar karwana hai to you will send it to another judge. Point number 14, उसी का नेक्स्ट पेज है. पॉइंट नंबर 14, द कोर्ट हैज टू कीप अ ट्रैक ऑफ द प्रोसीडिंग्स एक्सेप्टिंग आर्बिट्रेशन. तो उसके लिए कोर्ट टाइम फिक्स करता है कि इतने तारीख को आपको मीडिएटर के पास अपीयर होना है, और मीडिएटर को इंस्ट्रक्शन होगा कि इतने दिनों में, दो वीक में, तीन वीक्स में आपको रिपोर्ट फाइल करना है. ठीक. नंबर 15, नॉट सेंड द कोर्ट, वेन द कोर्ट सेंड फॉर मीडिएशन, ओरिजिनल रिकॉर्ड भेजने की जरूरत नहीं, यू सेंड कॉपीज. इसलिए पार्टीज की ड्यूटी होगी कि वेन दे फाइल देयर प्लीडिंग्स तो दे विल हैव टू फाइल द कॉपीज ऑल्सो, सो दैट ADR के लिए कॉपी भेजा जा सके. हाँ, अगर कोर्ट के प्रेमाइसेज में, कोर्ट के कंट्रोल में कोई एक मीडिएटर है एंड यू आर सेंडिंग द मैटर फॉर मीडिएशन टू दैट पर्सन, देन यू कैन सेंड द ओरिजिनल कॉपी ऑल्सो. ठीक. बट नॉर्मली दे विल बी सेंडिंग ओनली द जेरोक्स कॉपीज, बिकॉज हो सकता है ना ADR फेल हो जाए तो फिर मैटर वापस आए, तो ओरिजिनल डॉक्यूमेंट्स विल बी देयर विद द कोर्ट. दैट्स ऑल. तो ब्रॉडली दिस इज देयर, बट ADR अभी खत्म नहीं हुआ. वी हैव टू रीड ऑर्डर 10 रूल 1A, 1B, and 1C, प्लस वी हैव टू रीड एंड इंटरप्रेट सेक्शन 89, एंड देर आर सम टेक्निकलिटीज देयर, एंड उसके बाद कुछ और पॉइंट्स डिस्कस करना है हमको. सो दैट आई विल बी डूइंग टुमारो. टुमारो आई विल बी कंप्लीटिंग ADR, एंड आफ्टर ADR वी गेट इन टू ऑर्डर 14, 15, और उसके बाद तो फिर ऑर्डर 23 वगैरह आ जाएगा, 23, 22 एटसेट्रा.